Hello everyone! I have been working on a project recently that I've been sort of kind of documenting on Tumblr every so often called the Pokedex Project. It's me basically trying to legitimately complete the Pokedex in Pokemon Crystal here. Yeah, I've never actually done it before. In fact, I've never completed any Pokedex in the second generation of Pokemon games. You might be like, oh, how could you not do that? You always praise those games as being the best games of all Pokemon games ever, and, well, it's a sad story. Very sad story, in fact. So sad. I'm gonna need to put on some sad music, so here we go. I initially tried to complete the Pokedex in Pokemon Gold, and I made some good progress on it. I think I had 186 Pokemon captured, legitimately, and I had, I think it was 123 hours of gameplay. Those are the numbers I think they were. I'm not sure if they're exact, but that's what I remember offhand, so they very well might be. Because the game just randomly erased one day. Yeah, so that moment sort of was ingrained in my memories because it sort of killed the motivation to re-pursue completing the Pokedex because, you know, that could happen again in the future. And thus, I always just replayed the games as they were and, you know, just like, I didn't really go for collecting the Pokemon, I just played through the storyline and whatnot. Until I realized I had this. The Mega Memory Card, which I use to back up Pokemon game save files. Oops, got it the wrong way. because I had to change the battery. I don't know if you can tell on here, but I had to change the battery inside the game cartridges because the games actually lose their battery power much quicker than any other game cartridge or Game Boy cartridge because they have an internal clock. So what that does is, once it runs out of battery, you lose your game save file. And the funny thing about losing the Gold save file was that when I resumed playing Gold, it was just gone. And when I set up a new game, you know, I started playing a new game and saved it, it saved like nothing. So it wasn't like the battery was depleted or anything like that, it just randomly went kaput. Well, anyway, now that I have the Mega Memory Card, I realize I'm able to re-pursue my dream of completing a second-generation Pokemon game Pokedex. But we have ourselves sort of a problem here in the event Pokemon Mew and Celebi. Well, I traded over a Mew from my Red game, which I game sharked, so I don't know if you can really consider that all that legit, but I don't really... I mean, there is that Mew glitch, but that was discovered long, long after... I did the Game Shark thingamabob, but yeah, I could just redo the replay a yellow game and do the Mew glitch on the yellow game to get another Mew if I'd like. But I don't know. I'm kind of okay with doing the Game Shark thing with Mew because it's just like a Mew being put on your game via a event. Except I had to use Pokeballs to catch it in the wild at level 5 or something like that, but yeah, you get what I'm saying here, and that I'm content in the way that I set up the Mew to be like you got one from the Mew event. Well, I have a similar problem with Celebi, because the Celebi event was, you know, well, I should say it has been discontinued. There's no way to get Celebis in any of the second generation Pokemon games legit anymore, so you gotta... Well, I shouldn't say that. There's the option to use a glitch to sort of glitch out an egg to generate a Celebi using the move Beat Up, but I kind of question how legit that is because you can use that to generate pretty much any Pokemon. But then again, you know, you can do that with a Game Shark too, but the thing about getting a Celebi that way is you can get one as low as level 2, and the Celebi that you would normally get from Ilex Forest via the Celebi event in Crystal would be at level 30, so it doesn't really feel all that legit to me. So I gotta sort of gotta imitate the event that Nintendo was going to do in order for me to do this as legit as I possibly can, or at least that's what I determined. It's sort of debatable whether or not this is going to be legit or not, because it's not done natively within the game's cartridge, like doing the Celebi egg glitch, but I don't know, it just feels like the most legit thing to do, because then I'd have to catch it at Ilex Forest and whatnot. So, how exactly will we be able to do this legit?
Let's pretend that Nintendo decided to remake the events for the second generation of Pokemon games, and you went to go walk over to them because they have an event in your area. Well, they somehow lost the equipment to be able to transfer Celebi or the GS Ball to your game cartridge like they used to, but you find out that when you arrive at the official Celebi event, they are giving away a Game Shark for you to use. Yeah! So everyone that comes to this event gets a free Game Shark, and you'll be able to use it to get Celebis at any time, and it's but only if you use certain codes to activate the GS Ball event and whatnot, and then they'll consider it to be legitimate. So then you grab your Game Shark, and while talking to the Nintendo representative, you might decide to steal the Eevee and Wii Remote off to on top of your box here while you casually chat, and then you say your goodbyes to the Nintendo representative and casually walk away with stuff that you probably shouldn't have taken, but you got anyway.
Upon evading the security guard that was chasing you for your theft, you have successfully evaded him and made it home. And you have decided to record your upcoming triumph of collecting Celebi, the final Pokemon for your Pokedex, at home, connected to your Game Boy player, and you would like to record it for the world to see. Only Nintendo didn't exactly think of you having such an accessory, and it doesn't quite fit. Your GameCube has to be hanging over the edge slightly, so pressure isn't put on the game cartridge attached to said Game Shark. Upon entering this code and booting up the game, our quest for 100% Pokedex completion via getting a Celebi has begun. There's another code coming, but this is how you start it up here. So, are you ready? I am ready. I have been ready for a long, long time. In fact, I'm already set up here at Azalea Town. So let's head on over to the Mart and use this code to buy ourselves a GS Ball. But then you're like, oh, wait, the GS Ball. It's not on the list. Well, that's because I actually have to turn on the Game Shark. See, if you turn on the Game Shark before you boot up the game will just freeze. So here I go, I'm going to turn on the Game Shark here. It might cause some issues, but we'll see. Oh, little graphical glitch by that kid, but anyway, now you'll see some graphical glitches in here, but with the peas. But anyway, all I want to do is buy this GS Ball for zero Pokedollars. So it's less about actually buying it so much as it being given to me, just like the Nintendo event. So yes, got myself a GS Ball. And I am good to go, except for that it kind of froze here. So I gotta turn off the Game Shark again. And that should allow me to move, yep. And we've got a parenthesis that this kid is walking on. Can I talk to you? Oh, it disappears. Will it come back after I am done talking to you? No, it will not. So okay, the game is cured. Now, I gotta go over to Kurt to get the second part of this event going on here. So, let's go talk to him. I make balls from apricorns. Collect them from trees and bring them to me. I'll make balls out of them. Well, as you see, he won't accept your apricorn. But that's because you need to put in yet another Game Shark code. So, what you want to do from here is save your game and then go back over to the Game Shark's code input screen. Okay? Okay. The next code is this. We are golden, or silverin, or crystalline. No, forget it. So let's get the game going here again. And let's go talk to Kurt. Oh no, I didn't turn on the Game Shark again. So it looks like I'm gonna have to do that right now. So here we go, let's talk to him.
What is that? I've never seen one before. It looks a lot like a Pokeball, but it appears to be something else. Let me check it for you.
Oh, game's frozen. Gotta turn off the Game Shark. Okay, I'm gonna do that.
And, okay, things have resumed. I'm checking it now. Aha, I see. So, Dad works at Slif where he studies Pokeballs. I have to stay with home with Grandpa and Slowpoke.
So, as you can tell, he's looking at the Pokeball right now. And if we go back in, he's going to be over at the counter here, just like he's making a Pokeball. Grandpa's checking a ball right now, so I'm waiting till he's done. And I talk to him. I'm checking it now. Aha, I see. So he repeated his dialogue. Well, from here, we've actually got to wait a full 24 hours until he is done checking the Pokeball. So, let's save our game again, because he's in progress, and I'll see you tomorrow.
It's the next day, and I've got the Pokemon team here set up for the Celebi encounter, which will be at level 30. It's not really all that special of a team, just stuff that I got out of the PC as I was collecting Pokemon for the Pokedex and whatnot. Like, I picked Umbreon here, for instance. It's not like a competitive powerhouse or anything like that, but the reason why I chose it was because it's resistant to psychic attacks completely. You know, it's a dark type. And it's also got weak attacks like Quick Attack here to whittle down Celebi's HP. It also got stalling Pokemon like Tyranitar here because it's really defensive, and yeah, and Blissey got the super high special defense, and yeah, you get what I'm saying here. Rest, keep stalling. A Krabby, well, I just need Cut to get to where I need to go. It's one of those sorts of HM slaves you just make because you can't find your full HM slave, and yeah. And Pidgeot to fly around so I can show you stuff. Alright, now let's get the main event started here. Gotta go back over to Kurt because he should be finished examining the ball by now.
Crystal! This ball started to shake while I was checking it. There must be something to this.
And he runs out without saying a word.
Grandpa's gone. I'm so lonely.
You have a Slowpoke, and I'm here. How could you possibly be lonely? Like when your grandpa was over at the Slowpoke well. How? How? Forget it.
Ilex Forest is restless. What is going on? Crystal, here's your GS ball back. Could you go see why Ilex Forest is so restless?
Okay.
So we get the GS ball back. Got anything else to say?
Not really.
I mean, you'll repeat yourself over and over, but nothing new.
Grandpa's going on, same with you.
Alright, now, normally you're supposed to go to Ilex Forest for this event through here, but if you take the back route in, like, say, over at Goldenrod City... Actually, that's the only other route into Ilex Forest is down this route here, and yeah, so I'm gonna go back through Route 34 here and follow the path avoiding the grass. Yeah, and look, this lady's here, the lady that's usually by this Butterfree.
What's going on?
Something's wrong in Ilex Forest. You should stay away right now. So if you try to pass her,
you absolutely cannot pass her off that side, for she functions as a makeshift door guard in the meantime. So yeah, you cannot go through that way, hence why I absolutely need Cut to get to the shrine at the Ilex Forest. Alright?
Okay, so going in to the deep dark forest. Just seeing if they have any new dialogue here. No, that's not really new, but it does relate to what we're gonna do. Notice that the trees are moving a little bit. Anyway, I'm going to max repel here, because wild Pokemon encounters will happen as we're walking around this forest, so yeah. Alright, let's cut this. Cut, cut, cut. Go, Krabby, go! Yeah! Okay, now walking over here. Look at this. See this shrine? Ilex Forest Shrine. It's in honor of the forest's protector. Oh, what is this? It's a hole. It looks like the GS ball would fit inside it. Want to put the GS ball here? Sure! What could possibly happen if I put the GS ball in there?
Battle with Celebi, the forest protector!
Let's do this.
Alright, so I'm gonna attempt to see how I can scratch off HP. Yeah, that's a pretty good. I'm not gonna really bother with status effects because it's got heal bell like that, and yeah. I mean, I could put it to sleep and that would disable it from using heal bell until it wakes up, but you know, sleep wears off after a while, and I'm just gonna go with the basic attack and then start chucking Pokeballs at it. Strategy without paralyzing it or anything like that, because yeah, I'm just gonna. I think that'll be just fine if you ask me. Just as long as I don't get a critical hit. A critical hit would tick me off. Okay, that should be good. I think. That future sight, I think it'll still affect Umbreon, if I'm not mistaken. Anyway, I think I've got enough Ultra Balls here. I've been through the Elite Four a bunch of times, and I got a bunch of Moolah, and yeah, let's start chucking them! I don't know what its catch rate is, though. I'm guessing it's relatively high, because it's an event Pokemon. They want to make sure that you're going to be able to catch it in some way, shape, or form, because, you know, this is a faithful encounter, I guess they call it, or something like that. So, yeah, usually these sorts of encounters don't have that difficult of Pokemon to catch. And Nah, of course it's gonna fail, because the Future Sight was already going. Yeah, see, the Future Sight still hits Umbreon, because it's, it hits pretty much anything. Because, I mean, yeah, it is a psychic attack, but it seems to bypass resistances. Yeah. Oh, that's another thing. Safeguard prevents it from getting status effects as well, so that's another reason why I'm not bothering to inflict it with any status conditions or anything like that. And, oh, I got it! I got it! Yeah! That means my Pokedex is now 100% complete! Revered as a guardian of the forest, Celebi appears wherever beautiful forests exist. No. 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 And no. Hey, there's Kurtz. Whew, wasn't that something? Crystal, that was fantastic, thanks. The legends about the shrine were real after all. I feel inspired by what I just saw. It motivates me to make better balls. I'm going. Okay, you go. It looked like he went down this way, but that's not the path back to Azalea Town, is it? Or maybe he just got lost in the forest. Well, let's see if we go back over to him and see if he has anything else to say. I don't think so, because the event is over. Yep, it's over. So he has nothing more to say. However, I have something more to say. I have stuff to show you here that is sort of like a side effect of putting in that code. So let's get to them one by one, shall we? Gotta work out the bugs in the code after all, right? So anyway, going back over to here, look at this right here. See this? From the flower shop's Floria. Listen, listen! When I sprinkled water on that wiggly tree, it jumped right up! It just has to be a Pokemon. I bet it would be shocked out of its disguise if you soaked it. I know, I'll tell me my sister and borrow her water bottle. So, and then she leaves. Even though we've already got the squirt bottle. But yeah, the pseudo woodle was not here. However, inputting that code, for some reason, causes that text event to reset for some reason. And there are other events in this game that reset just like that one. Yes, I will. Anyway, another thing that happens when you input that code is that if you go back over to the Dragon's Den and head over to the Elder, you know, the one that gives you the Dratini, you will be able to get another one from him. Yeah, for some reason, that also resets. So let's go in there, and why did I press left there? I don't know. By the way, the music in this place is pretty cool. Yeah. Whee! La 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 la! Okay, I gotta use Whirlpool. Just messing around here. And there we go. La la, and we're here we are. Ooh, creepy. Good to see you here. Your arrival is most fortunate. I have something for you. Take this Dratini as proof that I have recognized your worth. And there's the Dratini! Oh yeah! Mm-hmm, 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 mm-hmm. Ho ho ho. So, and then after that, it'll be all back to normal, basically. Just like the girl with the pseudo-woodle. Basically, anytime you see one of these reset events, you'll be able to redo, or say, or rehear the dialogue or redo said event. And since I already had a Dratini, I thought I would just grab another one for kicks anyway, because it's not like it's going to affect my Pokedex or anything like that. So, yeah, that is pretty cool. Well, I suppose if you want a cheated Dratini. But, yeah, it doesn't really matter, in my opinion, at this point, because I already got a Dratini legitimately from him earlier. Now let's get our Pokedex evaluated! Yes, I would love to. Yes! 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 And that's what it sounds like when you have a Pokedex completed. There's one last thing that I would like to do. One last thing that I would like to do here is go over to Kanto, because I want to head over to the Celadon Hotel for something I think you are aware of already. Perhaps, maybe, from the first game? I should say the first generation of Pokemon. Whee! Look at us go! Okay, we're done. I don't know why, that's just kind of a hyper-energetic cutscene is kind of entertaining. And now I'm going to fly away to Celadon. Yeah, needless to say, I know how to get around this game pretty well. Alright, then here we are at the hotel. Wait, too far. Is that right? I'm the game designer. Filling up your Pokedex is tough, but don't give up. Wow! Excellent! You completed your Pokedex! Congratulations! Yeah! And I get a diploma! Player Crystal, this certifies that you have completed the new Pokedex. Congratulations! The graphic artist will print out the diploma for you. You should go show it off. Who's the graphic artist? Programmer? No. They steal my money. I'd rather buy the coins. Okay, you're the graphic artist. I'm sure! Let's print it! No! Yeah, I knew that would happen. I just wanted to do that for kicks. So yeah, you can print that out if you have a Game Boy printer and whatnot. So, yeah. Here it is. The completed Pokedex! Yes! I've waited so long to see this! So long! And yes, I do assure you that all of them are legit. You just have to take my word for it. But other than Mew and Celebi to an extent, because obviously Nintendo no longer has official events for those Pokemon anymore, so you just gotta kinda make do with what you have, you know, at the moment in time if you want to have completion, because, like, I guess you could say the rule to full completion changed once Nintendo stopped giving out the events, because, you know, it's kind of baloney that you can't complete your Pokedex, you know, if they won't, you know, support it or anything like that anymore, so you gotta do something about it, come on now! I mean, well, if you're a completist or something like that. Oh yeah! And with that, I'm gonna end off this video. I'm not gonna end it off just yet, I got a call. Hello, Tully here. What a perfect day for fishing. We should get a battle going. I'll be fishing on Route 42. Swing by if you have the time. Well, I'll be seeing you. No! I'm done! Game 100%ed. Video over. I hope everyone enjoyed. And I'll see you later. Kinda sound like evil voice guy there for a second. I also need to get out of this hotel. Yeah! Gotta fly home. Whee!